In this lecture, we will be looking into the concepts of polygon. Here you can see the definition of polygon. Polygons are closed planar shapes with three or more sides. So this is called as one side, two side, three side, four side. So this is a four-sided polygon. This is a three-sided polygon. This is again a four-sided polygon. This is a four-sided polygon. Here you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6-sided polygon. This is four-sided polygon. The shape can be of anything. See here, this is 4, this is 4, this is 4, this is 4. But the shapes are different. It doesn't matter. Polygons means you need the sides to be more than 3. 3 or more. Okay. So, some mathematical terminologies related to what is polygon is vertex. In plural, we call it as vertices. If it is one, we call it as vertex. If it is multiple, we call it as vertices. For example, if you have a polygon like this, this is called as vertex. When you combine all the vertex, it is called as vertices. So from this diagram, you can see what is the vertex. If you would combine two simple corners of a polygon, the corners of the polygon, each corner of the polygon is said to be a vertex. Okay. So these are called as vertices. When you go with consecutive sides, what is consecutive? The nearby, the next two. The consecutive side for this is this and this. Consecutive side for this is this and this. Okay. So the diagonals will be, for example, if I say, if I take this point as A, I will call this as B and C. So B and C are consecutive to A, but this D, E and F are non-consecutive. So the lines that draw from the point to the non-consecutive points are called as non-consecutive vertices, are called as diagonals. Okay. So with regard to A, B and C are consecutive. Okay. D, E and F are non-consecutive. Now we know which is consecutive and which are non-consecutive vertices. Okay, these are the vertices. And the next definition is diagonal. What are the diagonals here? If I start from A, what are the points that are connecting to the non-consecutive vertices are called as diagonals. AD, AE and AF are diagonals. Now we will see what is related to angles of polygon. Angles of polygon. Here you have two types of angles, interior and external. Okay. So, for example, if I take this polygon, we have A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. If I make diagonals from A, for example, if I take this point vertex as the diagonal point, from here I will make lines to non-consecutive vertices. That is what we call as diagonals. So these diagonals, now what we are going to see, we have small triangles inside this polygon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 triangles are there. We have 6 triangles. Okay. Here the sides are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 sides polygon. For 8-sided polygon, we have 6 triangles, small triangles within that. And we know that the sum of all internal angles of a triangle is 180. So here we have 6 angles, 6 triangles. So 6 into 180 is 1080 degree is the total angle of these polygons. Okay. And coming to the, this is regarding the interior angle. Coming to the exterior or external angle, you can see if I have a polygon like this, whatever angles I project to it, these are called as the external angles. Okay, so some of these are the external angles of the polygon. Internal means you will calculate internally, and external means you will calculate externally. These are some formulas mathematically used to calculate the sum of interior angle, or measure the each angle for the internal angle. This is the sum of each, this is each external angle, and this is the sum of exterior angles. For example, if I take this polygon, sum of these, all these triangles is this formula, and each triangle is this. So I am dividing it by n, and for exterior angle it will be divided, each exterior will be divided by n, and this will be multiplied by n. This is sum of exterior angle. So these four formulas are used, are to be used in all the problems which we see now. Find the sum of internal angle of six-sided polygon. Here you see the formula, sum of interior angle of n-sided polygon is n minus 2 into 180. So the formula is n minus 2 into 180. It is mentioned six-sided polygon. So 6 minus 2 into 180, which is 4 into 180. You can have it as 720 degree. This is the sum of the six-sided polygon. The same formula we can use for another problem, eight-sided polygon. It is n minus 2 into 180. It is 8 minus 2 into 180. So it is 6 into 180, which is nothing but 1080 degree. Same if we calculate for 10 sided, n minus 2 into 180. 10 into 10 minus 2 into 180. So it is 8 into 180, nothing but 1440 degree. When you go for the problem related to external angle of a 12-sided polygon, external angle, sum of external angle is this formula. So we will be using n into 180 minus n minus 2 into 180 degree divided by n. This is the formula mentioned here. Okay. So what I will do now, n is equal to 12. It is mentioned n, number of sides is 12 sided. So 12 into 180 minus 12 minus 2 into 180 divided by 12. We are just replacing all the n with 12. Okay. So it is 12 into 180 minus 10 into 180 divided by 12, which is nothing but 12 into 180 minus 1800 divided by 12, which is 12 into 180 minus 150 is equal to 12 into 30. So the value is 360 degree. Okay. This is another problem which is related to the internal angles. But look at the formula here. What is asked here? If the sum of internal angles is, they have given the internal angle sum. This, in this problem, they have given the number of sides and asked you to find the sum. Here the sum is provided and asked you to find the number of sides. So the same formula you are going to use, n minus 2 into 180 is equal to 1260. N minus 2 is equal to 1260 divided by 180, which is nothing but 7. So n minus 2 is equal to 7, n is equal to 9. So the number of sides is 9. Hope you understand this.